we have some information. We're still limited with the USGS, but it is coming up now in just a moment. 6.4, originally 6.6. That's not unusual, the drop, but only 5 miles in depth. Typically around the world, a lot of times these will be 100, 200 miles deep. The shallower they are, the more shaking stays at the surface. Of course, a lot of it has to do with the soil content and the makeup of that. Let me move on, because that was at 10:33 local time in the morning. They've had significant aftershocks, and I'll show you in just a moment some of the maps. It's much more than we expected. Dr. Lucy Jones is saying this is not along the San Andreas Fault. This is an area of much smaller faults. And since back in the 80s, there used to be a number of smaller quakes in this area that were 5.0 magnitude or higher. However, this is right now, we believe, the strongest magnitude 6 quake in Southern California since 1999, when they had a little bit larger one. Now, when you have quakes of this size, 6.4 or higher, even 6 to 6.9. There's 134 of them that happen around the world annually. But this is going to blow your mind, because this is what could still happen. When you have a 6.4 magnitude quake, how many aftershocks can you have, and what is typical? It's typical to have at least one that is a 5.4 or higher. We've had a 4.7. That would fall into this category. How many at 4.4 or higher? We could have 10 of those after this event. How many at 3.4 higher? 100. Let me take you now, show you this map here, Boog. This is going to blow your mind as well. It's hard to see, so we're going to zoom in on this. If we can take this full, any little yellow dot you see here is a tremor in the last week. Now, they're all over. We're going to zoom in here for you, see it a little bit better. Anything in orange is the last 24 hours, and then anything in red is today. Let's get in tighter. You can see the mountainous area. There's Bakersfield. We're going to move out. Ridgecrest is this little area down there, but that's 30,000. So this is our main quake at 6.4. It's a larger dot of red. Now I'm counting now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 aftershocks. Well, one could have been the 4 shock, obviously, the 4.7. Mm-hmm. But again, this is just beginning. And this could go on for hours, days. Even possibly weeks. Let's just hope that the energy is being released now, so this is not the 4 shock and there's a stronger one that follows. But there could be some shaking going on, not just today, but for the rest of the week into next week.
All those aftershocks. I'm Tom Sater. Thank you so much. We'll come back to you as we continue this coverage here. I've got a seismologist with me now, Susan Huff, from the USGS. And Susan, you are in LA. So let me just ask you the first question, which is, did you feel it?
I was actually driving through central LA on the way to the airport to pick up my husband. I did not feel a thing, although on the radio, they were instantly talking about having felt it.
Yeah. And when you hear now 6.4, put it in perspective for us.
Yeah, that is a good size earthquake, as you've heard. I mean, it's close to the 1994 Northridge earthquake. And what makes all the difference was Northridge was in the middle of a city, whereas this was in a fairly remote area. The closest good-sized town is indeed Ridgecrest, which is, my family has lived in that area since 1946. It's remote. It was started as a Navy base for weapons testing in a remote area, but it's a good-sized town. As you heard, 30,000 people, and given the magnitude and the distance, I would expect at least some light damage in that town.
Listening to you, I was listening to a note of Tom Sater's a second ago. He was saying the last couple of weeks there have been smaller tremors in Southern California, and that seismologists have been taking note, maybe waiting for something like this. Is that typical ahead of something of this magnitude?
I'm not aware of any foreshocks in that immediate area. There has been a spattering of trees in different areas, but we get magnitude threes on an almost daily basis through Southern California, so I haven't seen any notable uptick in recent weeks.
What would you, just last question, is you know, we know those aftershocks will continue for some period of time. What's your message to folks in this part of the country?
Yeah, as listeners just heard, that they are going to continue to feel aftershocks. There is a small chance that an even bigger earthquake can happen, as they heard. This could, in fact, be the foreshock to something bigger. It's only about a 1 in 20 chance. It is anything that happens in that area, it's still going to be remote. But, you know, earthquakes are possible any day in any part of California, and they don't take holidays.
Okay. Susan, thank you so much for hopping on the phone with me. Please continue on and grab your husband from LAX, and a happy 4th to you and your family. Let me get to this sound. This is from a witness who was actually near the epicenter of this quake. This is from KCBS. Here you go.
Oh, yeah. Well, everything fell. We were, I was in the house. My boyfriend was here. He just left to go to his house. And plants fell. Pictures fell off the wall. Oh, there's another aftershock. Everything, things fell out of the cupboards. It was scary. It felt way bigger than a 6.4, for sure.
And Susan, is everybody okay in your neighborhood? Did people go outside? Have you talked to any of your neighbors?
I haven't talked to any of the neighbors. I was on the phone with my sister, and she can see fires in town that are burning from her house. She lives up a little higher than I am. And at her house, she has a big shop, and all the tool chests, the big tool chests with all the tools in them, all fell over. Everything fell out of her cupboard. She said there was glass all over her kitchen, on the floor, everything. Like, it was huge here. It was unbelievable. It was the worst one I've ever felt.
What about the power? Is your power still working?
My power is working, and my gas line looks okay. The cars were like bouncing up and down. It was just incredible. Everything, it was huge here. It was so scary. I've never felt one. Well, I was in Big Bear for the Landers quake, and it was as big as that, for sure.
And describe the community to me, Susan. Is it mostly flat area? Is it pretty hilly? You said your sister saw fires. Can you describe the landscape?
Well, yes, very flat. We're down in a valley. We're about 45 minutes from Death Valley. Mm-hmm. And so it's a very flat community. There's a naval base here, is what the hub of the community is, from the Naval Weapons Center. So it's a very flat area, but we're still experiencing a lot of aftershocks. Like, they're constant. We had a little one this morning, too. It didn't wake me up. I guess there was like a little precursor of 4-point mm-hmm. something, about 10. Did you guys feel that one?
All right, so that's someone who most definitely felt it and was assessing the damage in her own home. Let's go back to you, Sarah Seidner, in Los Angeles, in our bureau there, because I know we've been wondering about, you know, damage assessments throughout this part of, you know, California. What have you learned?
So we talked to, as I said earlier, a hotelier who says that they definitely have damage there. They felt the floor ripple, but we have just gotten another report. You heard the woman there talking about fires. Another person that lives in Ridgecrest has said she definitely sees fires. She is concerned about that. As you know, when these happen, sometimes they can, for example, break gas lines and that sort of thing, which can create fires. We saw that happen in the San Francisco earthquake there, where a whole area was basically burned down in the marina because of that. So that's always a huge concern, which is why they tell people, turn off your gas if you can, turn off your water, you know, prepare yourself in these sorts of things. But you have no warning. And so when they just happen, that's why right after, if everything is okay and you're in a safe spot and you can do these things, you should definitely do some of the things that you're taught here in California. I was just also speaking, you know, Lucy Jones, who is a renowned seismologist, has said that, yes, there was a slight warning. A 4.2 magnitude quake happened there in Ridgecrest about a half an hour before a larger quake happened. But you don't know that because we get little earthquakes all the time. People mm-hmm. are relatively used to having a small shake, and then they go, oh, wow, we just experienced an earthquake. When there's no damage, there are no issues, it doesn't feel big, you go about your day, you go about your business. One of the things that could be good here is that it is a holiday. There isn't a lot of traffic, not a lot of folks out on the roads, whether you're in Los Angeles or in Ridgecrest. That can be a good thing, because as you know, those overpasses and all of the freeways that are here can be vulnerable in these kinds of earthquakes. It's what we saw, for example, in Northridge, which was a 6.4, and that created quite a bit of damage. One of the big pictures that we all remember, Brooke, right, is when a overpass caved in, fell in, and you saw that sort of damage, which was incredibly scary to people. I've just been, and I can't help it because it's one of the tools that everyone uses now to find
Twitter.
Out what's going
it's
on
okay.
in the area. Twitter, right? but this comes from Ava DuVernay, and everybody knows who she is. She is a renowned director who has won quite a few awards, and she lives here in Los Angeles. She's lived here her entire life. And she says that was the longest earthquake I have ever experienced. Not jerky, smooth and rolling. That describes it perfectly. It was rolling. It did feel like it went on for quite a long time, long enough for people to get on Twitter and show the video of things happening. I can tell you here in the Los Angeles area, and we're about 156 miles away from Ridgecrest. So giving you some idea that it's being felt all over the place. Santa Barbara, Pasadena, all of these places have felt it. But we should also mention Las Vegas felt it. And Las Vegas may have felt it even stronger. Why? Because of where this particular earthquake was centered. Ridgecrest is actually closer to Las Vegas than it is to, for example, Los Angeles. So wherever this is epicentered, that is where you're going to feel the strongest and have the most potential for damage and injuries.